On NHRA Today, we check in with Indianapolis Bureau Chief John Kernan on what happened to Jack Beckman in round number one at Wild Horse Pass Raceway at the Arizona Nationals. Lewis Bloom in the Wally Park studio, delivered by Papa John's. Joining us from Indianapolis, our Bureau Chief, John Kernan. John, what happened to Jack Beckman?
Well, believe it or not, they basically exploded the clutch. That's not something you'll see because of the bell housing, but when he did the burnout, broke a piece, and then it all got rattled around, tore it up inside. But talk with John Medlin, the co-crew chief on the Infinite Hero team today, and he told me the one thing that they were thankful for is the bell housing did its job. It kept their driver safe. None of those broken parts flying around inside the bell housing came out.
As we mentioned earlier, anytime there's an explosion in the bell housing, we have safety features designed in the bell housing. They're mandated by SFI. And this is a good example of a bell housing. This isn't exactly the one that was on the car, but it's a very good picture of it. And you can see here that at some point or another, there was some damage on the inside of the bell housing. But this liner, this smooth piece, is held into this bell housing by an anti-rotation bolt. And that anti-rotation bolt is aluminum. It's designed so that when the parts and pieces try to contact the inside of the bell housing, that the liner catches those pieces and it rotates. It rotates and it takes the energy in the liner and it takes it away from the outside of the bell housing, which is designed to contain the parts and pieces. In our case, this liner worked absolutely perfect. It prevented any parts and pieces from getting outside of the bell housing. It contained all of the energy, and the liner did its job. So when we get our bell housing back, it's going to look just like this. There'll be some dings on the inside of the bell housing, but the liner will be replaced and it'll be perfect. The bell housing goes through a testing procedure at the manufacturer, and they certify that the bell housing is intact, just like it was brand new. Replace the liner, we'll put it back in the race car.
Lewis, they put the backup clutch in the car and stayed over to test at Phoenix on Monday, and everything went great. They're going to be ready for Gainesville.
Well, Jack Beckman holds the record there, the track record at 3.879 seconds. I believe that'll get demolished probably in the first session. But funny car, very competitive class, and I expect to see big things from Jack in the next coming races.
Yeah, Gainesville, the ET all depends upon the weather. If it's dry and cool, you're near sea level, you can make a lot of horsepower there. And if the conditions are right, we might actually see that first run in the 370s for a funny car. But it has to be like perfect conditions for that to happen.
We just want it to be a dry weekend at the Gator Nationals. John, thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
For more content, keep it right here at NHRA.com. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.